go outside on the hottest day of summer, and you'll see dogs, cats, squirrels, bears, hares, marmots, and pretty much any other mammal doing this. It's called splooting. Yes, that's now an accepted scientific term for the adorable way animals spread their legs out.
It's this summer's coolest trend. This viral behavior, sometimes also called frogging or pancaking, is more than a shameless call for attention. For many animals who don't sweat, this is one of the most efficient ways to cool down.
Splooting helps animals thermoregulate by cooling down their bellies. The water content of the soil keeps it cooler than the air, and on very warm days, it can be up to 5 degrees colder. This is why you might catch your dog digging a hole in the garden to sit in. It's science.
Domestic animals and park critters might get all the attention for this behavior, but while making this show, we've seen lots of wild animals splooting away the heat. From Tasmanian devils trying to beat the heat down under and taking a break from the rough and tumble life of being the island's apex predator.
Would you believe that these scrappy little guys behind me are actually Tasmania's largest predator?
To massive dog towns of prairie dogs in the prairies, keeping watch of their colonies and scanning for coyotes while they let the grasslands absorb their body heat. To two of the greatest predators on Earth, who on an unseasonably warm day decided to come chill right next to us.
Oh my gosh, it's just a bear sploot. I see my cat do this at home, but seeing the largest carnivoran in the world do the same pose is just mind-blowing.
That was one of the best days of my life.
Researchers believe that splooting not only helps the animals cool down, but also helps them stretch their backs and relax their muscles.
It's the animal version of self-care, like having a cold drink in a pool on a sunny day, except the pool is made of dirt.
Animals with short legs have a much easier time, which is why you see tree-climbing animals like squirrels and diggers like marmots and small dog breeds do it more often. Animals with long legs like giraffes and maned wolves also love a lay down on the ground to cool down, but they do it in much less hilarious ways.
It's also important to know that some dogs and cats begin splooting more often when they're in pain. So if you notice your pet adorably laying down like this more than usual, keep an eye on it.
Splooting is one of the many ways nature has to lower animal temperatures. Sweating is the main method that you're most familiar with.
There are special kinds of sweat glands under your arms and in other parts of your skin. These glands have little ducts to carry the sweat or perspiration to the outside air.
When humans, other primates, and other mammals like horses and hippos overheat, sweat glands release liquid to the surface of the skin. These droplets then evaporate, absorbing heat from your body and dissipating it into the air. Kangaroos don't sweat, but they lick or spit into their own arms for the same reason. But they're a lot more gross about it.
It's a similar strategy to what vultures do. They poo on their legs and wait for it to evaporate. You know, being sweaty is pretty awesome in comparison.
A lot of other animals who can't sweat pant instead. Panting, not to be confused with pantsing, works by accelerating the evaporation rate of the humidity in the animal's respiratory tract. Dogs will also stick their tongue out while panting to help cool down even further. In the case of saigas, their nose and respiratory passages are so wide that they can easily avoid overheating during the scorching Central Asian steppe summers.
It's kind of like sweating, but it only happens in the mouth and throat. In any case, the main idea remains the same. Turn your body heat into hot liquids and let them evaporate. Some animals push this even further by bringing in external objects to cool down. The most effective of them? Mud.
Oh, my poor little pig!
I'm a-coming, Jenny.
Pigs get a bit of a bad rep for loving bathing in mud, but mud is one of the most efficient ways to cool down. Mud dissipates heat even faster than sweat. And for mammals on the heavier side, it's a gift from nature.
Oh my God, buddy. What have you done? Gus. Oh my God.
Oh. You are filthy, buddy.
Large mammals have a smaller body surface relative to body mass, so it's harder for them to stay cool. Pigs, elephants, rhinos, hippos, water buffaloes, and tapirs are all known for loving mud. We actually got to see a wild tapir enjoying a refreshing mud bath in Costa Rica, fully unbothered by us. The power of mud.
And on top of helping them beat the heat, it helps them fight off parasites. But if you don't want to get messy, a drier way of losing body heat is through your ears.
Ears are full of veins and arteries that play a big role in thermoregulation. Elephants, hares, and many desert animals, like fennec foxes, jerboas, and jackrabbits, have massive ears. When the animal is hot, blood is pushed to the ears, which are very thin and provide lots of surface area for the heat to dissipate. On the other hand, animals that live in colder temperatures tend to have little ears and are shaped as spherically as possible to prevent heat from escaping their bodies.
Birds don't have external ears, yet, but the soft skin in their throat serves the same purpose.
Hot weather birds, like pelicans and frigate birds, do their own version of this through a process called gular fluttering. They shake their heads while sometimes inflating their bills. On the inside, the fast-moving air evaporates liquids, similar to dog panting. And on the outside, the hot throat tissue gets cooled down by the air.
Eusocial animals like bees have to worry about keeping themselves cool and preventing beehive overheating. Air ventilation is key, so the workers do a cooling behavior called bearding.
Here's a bee that's in the ventilating system. It's waving its wings at the door of the hive to create a breeze in the hive. Now, it waves its wings about 200 times a second, and to cool a hive in summer. In winter, it will do waving of that kind inside the hive to develop heat to keep the hive warm.
The bees exit the colony and arrange themselves in a beard-like formation while fanning their wings to help air circulate throughout the colony. This can be a scary sight, as it looks similar to when they're beginning to swarm. But in most cases, all they're doing is trying to stay cool.
Reptiles and other cold-blooded animals rely on the environment to keep themselves in the right temperature window. But one species in particular has developed their own version of a water cooling system.
The thorny devil lives in some of the hottest places in the world, the deserts of Australia. Water is scarce, but the thorny devil manages to absorb every possible drop of moisture thanks to specialized openings in its skin. Then it looks for burrows to stay away from the punishing southern sun.
Sometimes, the best way to stay cool is by not getting hot in the first place. Some animals in the Sahara have evolved strategies to stave off the heat.
The coolest of them is the Saharan silver ants. These ants sprint to prevent absorbing heat from the hot sand, which at times can get up to 50 degrees Celsius.
Their long legs move them at 0.8 meters per second, making them the fastest of over 12,000 known ant species. Every second, they travel 108 times their own body length. For you to do that, you'd have to run at about 700 kilometers an hour, just slightly slower than the average speed of an airplane.
On top of their speed, they're covered in hairs that reflect heat and can also dissipate heat in the air.
They're amazing creatures. But you kind of have to be to survive in a warming world. As the planet gets hotter, more animals will need to develop strategies to stay cool. So what should we talk about next? Please let me know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thanks for watching, stay cool, and see ya! It's a similar strategy to what vultures do. They poo on their legs and wait for it to evaporate.
Now, Danielle, how much money would it take for you to change sweating to pooing on your legs to cool down your body?
Like, as a strategy for myself?
So it's like now, from now on, you can only cool yourself down by pooing on your legs, but you get a dollar amount to make that change.
Can I control when it happens and where, or is it like, oh no, I'm
fine.
Oh,
like, oh no.
Yeah, I guess you could control it because it is pooing on your leg. So, okay. So what's your number?
Like 50 billion. Let's go. Oh, I'm gonna save the world by pooing on my legs.